Hey guys, so today I'm going to be taking the Tartlet in Bloom palette, and first I'm going to take the color Flower Child on a MAC 224 brush and start blending that into my crease. I also already applied tape on the outer corner of my eyes so my eyeshadow can have a straight line, and it also helps prevent fallout. Then taking the color Smarty Pants on the same MAC 224 brush, I'm going to start blending that into my crease. You want to make sure to stay on the upper half of your crease and try not to blend it down onto the lid. Then taking the colors Sweetheart and Rebel mixed together on a Morphe M209 brush, I'm going to place that into the crease. Again with this shadow, you want to make sure to keep it on the upper half of the crease and not blend it down onto the lid. Then taking the color Smoke Show on a Scone Smudger brush, I'm going to start tracing out my crease. It doesn't have to be that dark of a line because we're going to go back and fill it in later. Then on an e.l.f. smudger brush, we're going to take the colors Smoke Show and Activist mixed together and start blending out that line that we've created. This brush is a little bit bigger than the last one, making it easier to blend. Then after blending out that line, I'm going to take MAC Reflex Gold Pigment on a Morphe M224 brush and start placing that on my lid. If you accidentally got some eyeshadow on your lid, you can always carve out your crease with concealer, but since I didn't, I'm just going to go straight in with the pigment. If you want to, you can always make your brush wet when applying the pigment to make the sparkle more intense. Then taking that same e.l.f. smudger brush, I'm going to take the color Smoke Show and start re-intensifying the crease, just in case any color got covered up by the pigment. I also like to really blend out my outer corner to make it very smoky. Then taking the color Sweetheart with the same Morphe M209, I want to make sure the crease is well blended. Now I'm going to remove the tape from my eyeshadow, which leaves me with a straight line. Now to my face, I'm taking some lotion by BWC, and it's the Premium Botanical Fragrance-Free Hand and Body Treatment. I really like it because it makes my face tacky and it makes me feel like my makeup is sticking to it. Then I take the Maybelline Baby Skin Primer. I only apply this in my T-zone, like my cheeks, nose, forehead, and chin, just to blur out my pores. This is one of the best drugstore primers that I've found so far. Then I'm taking the Nivea Men Post Shave Balm in Sensitive, and I'm going to use it as a primer and apply it all over my face. I found that you have to apply a lot for it to work, and you have to really massage it into the skin. And you might be wondering, why am I taking aftershave balm, but all I have to say is shouts out to Nikki Tutorials. And as you can tell, I massage it into my face for forever. You have to massage it really good until it feels tacky, then you know that it's ready. Then I'm taking MAC Studio Fix Fluid onto the back of my hand. I'm the color NC20. No, NC15. Whoops. And I'm going to dot that all over my face. I mean, I apply a lot, but I love full coverage, so I don't want to see my real skin. Then I spray MAC Fix Plus over the foundation before I blend it in to give it more moisture. Since I find since it's full coverage, it's kind of drying. So I want to add more moisture into my skin. Then taking my Morphe M439 foundation brush, I'm going to blend that foundation into my skin. This is like my holy grail blending brush. It is like so good for foundation, like you can't even tell I have it. I mean, obviously I do, but I want to think that I don't. And you want to make sure to really work the foundation into the skin so it's not patchy or blotchy anywhere. Then since I have really dark under eyes, I'm going to take this orange concealer from my LM Minerals Contour Palette. I just like to dot this under my eye using my finger because then I feel like I get more coverage. Then taking my very dirty Real Techniques Beauty Blender, I just blend out that concealer under my eyes so it blends well with my foundation and I can put the concealer over it. Then I take the NYX HD Concealer on the color, let me see, Porcelain. And I like to apply that under both of my eyes in a triangle on my chin and nose and forehead just to highlight the face. Then again, taking my Real Techniques Beauty Blender, I'm just going to blend out my concealer, making sure it's very blended in and like seamless. Then taking the Airspun powder in Naturally Neutral, I take the Beauty Blender and dip it into the powder and apply it under my eyes. I really pack it on to pretty much bake my eyes. Well, that is what I'm doing. So it doesn't crease throughout the days and it gives like a more highlighted effect. Then taking the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit, I just take the brush that comes with it and I start carving out my cheeks. Pretty much contouring, but I like this brush better because it gives like a precise effect, and I haven't really found a soft enough brush that I like that can do the job that this little tiny brush can do. Then with the Zoeva 126 brush, I start blending out that contour line but not adding any more product. Then with that same brush, I take the Morphe 9C palette and I take the shade in the middle row to the far right to start applying that on my temples and the top of my forehead just around my hairline. As you can tell, it's very, very pigmented and I didn't realize that because I barely got it today. And so you need to be very light-handed and top off all the excess, like all of it. Then from the same palette, the bottom left corner, I apply it to my chin and the jawline to cover up that double chin. Then with the Zoeva 220 brush, I take the middle bottom row color from that 9C palette and I start contouring my nose. Then taking the Morphe 9B palette, I take that left blush color on any blush brush and apply it to my cheeks. This is also very pigmented, so you need to make sure you tap it off, otherwise your blush can go crazy real fast. Then from that 9C palette, I take the top two highlight shades on a Morphe M176 and brush off that powder after it's done sitting. I like to take a colored powder and brush it off because it's adding more color instead of just taking it away. Then on just this e.l.f. flat contour brush, I take that Airspun powder again and start carving out the contour I made. Sometimes the contour can go a little too low, so I like to carve it out with some powder and let it sit there so it can have a sharp, crisp line. Then for my eyebrows, I take the Anastasia Brow Wiz in medium brown and trace my bottom and top brow, and then I fill it in while brushing it out with a little spoolie on the Brow Wiz just so I don't have too much product and you don't get those sharpie eyebrows. As I get towards the front of my eyebrows, I use a very light hand and brush it out constantly just so it can be more tapered and faded, like an ombre effect. And then after that, I like to take the Dip Brow by Anastasia and the Anastasia number 12 brush and just define the tail more. Then again, taking that 9C top two highlight shades and the same Morphe M176, I brush off the powder underneath my contour. As you can see, after doing that, it leaves the contour very sharp. Then taking a Morphe M169 brush and the color Smarty Pants from the Tarte Lip palette, I start smudging it underneath my eyes. Then taking the color Sweetheart and Rebel on that same Morphe M169 brush, I'm just going to smudge that right under the color Smarty Pants. Then taking Activist and Leader, I'm going to smudge that just on the outer corner of my eyes. Then taking Skin Dimitri James Sugar Lip Lip Scrub, I'm just going to exfoliate my lips before I apply lipstick. Then I just wipe it all off after I'm done. Then going back in with my foundation brush with no extra product, I just mute out my lip tone. Then I'm taking the Lord & Barry lip liner and the color Nude and just outlining my lips and filling them in. I like to overdraw my lips a little bit because I have like no lips at all, like none. So I like to overline them to make it appear that I actually have some lips. Then I like to rub my lips together to transfer the lip liner to my top lip to kind of give me an outline of where I want to trace with the lip liner. Yes, I did it so messy, like I don't know, I couldn't draw my lips on for the life of me, but just bear with me. Then I'm filling in my lips with the Lolita 1 liquid lipstick. Then I'm taking Defri Star Celebrity Skin Liquid Lipstick and applying that over the top of the lip liner and Lolita 1. Then taking ColourPop's Liquid Lip and the color Limbo, I like to dot it all over my bottom lip and then transfer it to the top lip and blend it out with my finger just to give the color a little more darkness but still make it a nude lip. Then taking that same NYX concealer we used to highlight, I'm going to take it on a small, tiny detailer brush and then just carve out my lipstick because today I couldn't apply my lipstick at all, so I needed to really fix up the lip line so it's very nice and straight and not like wobbly. Then I take Becca Cosmetics highlighter in the color Pearl with a Morphe M176 brush and I like to apply it on the top of my cheekbone, above my eyebrow, on my nose, and on my cupid's bow. This highlight is a little white, so if you don't have fair skin tone, then I don't think this color would work for you. And then after applying my highlight, I also like to freshen up my blush because it kind of gets muted out by all of the bronzer and highlighter. Then I like to apply MAC Fix Plus for the final step of my makeup just to set it all in place.